We are going to learn how to manage Teams meetings more effectively. The first thing to understand is even if you are attending an in-person meeting, still create a Teams meeting and one person in the room should join the meeting. Why? Watch till the end, then you will understand. Only the meeting is in the calendar. The follow-up, collaterals, minutes of meeting, action items, notes, updates, reminders, all these things do not have anything to do with that calendar entry. All these happen in email and that floods our inbox, creates confusion, and everyone is searching for what happened in the past. So more effort, less impact means inefficiency. To avoid that, everything about the meeting will be a part of the meeting. How to get this done? I will explain as we go along. Three parts of the meeting lifecycle: organizing the meeting, attending the meeting, and post-meeting follow. You can organize the meeting in Outlook, add a Teams meeting to it, save it, but an extra step is required now. Go to Teams calendar, open the same meeting, scroll down, and then you will see a place for adding agenda. Click on it, add the agenda there. The next best practice is meeting settings. Most people, when they organize meetings, don't look at meeting options at all. Senior people, important customers are randomly hanging on in the lobby. It's a crowded meeting and everyone is a presenter. All these chaotic things can be prevented at the time of creating the meeting. Think of what the meeting is about, how many people are attending, who are they, what are their roles, and then tweak at least two settings. Who needs to be in the lobby, if at all? And second, who needs to be presenter? If you're not sure, just say, I am the presenter, that means the organizer. And when people join, you figure out. Making everyone a presenter by default always leads to confusion, especially in large meetings. As I said earlier, before the meeting actually happens, participants may want to discuss the agenda, or the presenters may want something to be pre-read, or there may be collateral files to be looked at, or there could be a survey to be filled. All these activities must happen inside the meeting. How do you do that? So I am going to this calendar entry. I am one of the attendees. Double click on it or right click and say chat with participants. So all the discussion about the meeting happens there. The agenda is also visible and it is editable. Collateral files can be uploaded, and anything else which is relevant can be added. Now let's talk about managing the meeting itself. The first thing is to start the recording and transcript. No brainer, but very often people forget to do that. The recording is useful as a future reference, but remember it expires after 60 days by default. If you want to extend it, open the recording later and change the expiry date or remove the expiry date. You can use the transcript to create a more formal minutes of meetings later. Whenever people join the meeting, they're going to see the agenda. Everyone is able to modify the agenda, reorder it, mark it as complete. So agenda is now an interactive, collaborative activity. Similarly, meeting notes can also be taken by everyone. Everyone can see the notes, modify the notes, so that by the end of the meeting, these notes have no ambiguity left. Of course, if you want to take notes for your own purpose, you can use OneNote independent of these notes. Finally, action items, which is probably the most important part of the meeting, are now integrated with the meeting. As and when an action item crops up, add it there, assign it to the person concerned, and give it a deadline. Agenda, meeting notes, and action items are essentially loop components. And if you want, you can add other loop components like tables, voting, bulleted list, numbered list, and more. The last best practice at the end of the meeting is important. It is to make sure that everyone in the meeting understands that we are going to use the meeting chat for all future follow-up for this meeting and nobody is going to send a mail. Now let's talk about post-meeting follow-up. The first thing to understand is where to find the meeting for further follow-up. In the calendar, the meeting will always be there. So double-click on the meeting. All the things which have happened so far in the meeting will be there, like the chat, meeting notes, agenda status, action items, recordings, transcripts, whiteboard if it was used, and so on. Now, anything you want to do further, like providing updates, asking questions, uploading files, can be done right there. You can also mark tasks as complete or even add more tasks if required. To see all your tasks across meetings, you don't have to open each meeting one by one. Instead, you go to the To-Do app, Assign to Me section. There you will get a consolidated list. Assign to Me shows you all the work given to you across meetings, planner, and any other loop task components. Now, what happens in recurring meetings? The agenda, meeting notes, and action items carry forward across instances of the meeting. So you don't have to copy paste, or you don't have to keep searching what was discussed 2 months back. Having said that, the best practice for recurring meetings is not to create traditional recurring meetings at all. Why? Anything which is a recurring meeting is some long-term objective. So it's better to manage it as a team in Teams rather than just in calendar as recurring meetings. That way, all the aspects of the recurring meeting remain as an integral part of the team in Teams. So the last thing is the first item. Why create a Teams meeting when it is an in-person meeting? You already know the answer. Even if it is in-person meeting, you want to keep track of what was discussed, the agenda, notes, action items, collaterals, follow-up, and so on. And you already saw how easy it becomes when it's a part of Teams meeting. So even if it's in-person meeting, create a Teams meeting. One person join the meeting, enable recording, take notes there. Apply the same process here. So now the ball is in your court. Try this out, convince your team members, start using it, share it with as many people as you can, and then let me know what was the impact. Did you find it useful? Did it improve your efficiency? Did I miss anything? All kinds of feedback is most welcome. So that's it for now. Thank you.